This is the Louie T Network. Hey, either you're outside or you're
in the lab room.
Bam! Free agency hits you like a diamond cutter out of nowhere. Welcome to the program. Of course, I am your man, Louie T. Free agency has hit like a bomb. And I'm talking about trades, we're talking about guys signing all over the place. I'm here to talk about some trades really quickly. Man, this is like no other free agency we've ever seen before. Right out of the gate, soon as it turned 4 o'clock, three bombshell trades right after another. Let's break them down in sequential order. The first trade I heard about, Seahawks get Jimmy Graham. Wait a minute. Seahawks get who? Wait, the same Jimmy Graham? He's a man that went through all of that arbitration to figure out if he was a tight end or a receiver, and the Saints were going to franchise tag him. That same Jimmy Graham that the Saints went through all that trouble for, they trade him for Max Unger, who was basically injured all of last season, but went healthy, a really good center, and a first round pick. What is going on? I mean, guys are just flying all over the place. The Seahawks definitely win here. If you're Seattle, because again, you take pick 31 and you say to yourself, at pick 31, am I getting a Jimmy Graham caliber player? Most likely the answer to that is no. So essentially, giving away your first round pick means nothing if you're the Seahawks. With all the talent you have on your team, adding Jimmy Graham to an already loaded football team means this team is making a concerted effort to get back to that mountaintop again. And they just got a huge weapon, a huge bit of ammunition in the form of Jimmy Graham. If you're the Saints, you get another first round pick to try to help your team. So now you have two first rounders and you add another interior offensive lineman in Max Unger. It's a good trade for the Saints, but to me, the Seattle Seahawks definitely win in that exchange. You look at another trade, and this one was basically goodbye to Ndamukong Suh right here. The Detroit Lions trade a mid-level pick. Now, I'm not sure what the compensation is. I'm hearing a fourth and a fifth, and I've also heard fourth or. That's a big thing there, because and means they're getting both, or means they're getting one or the other. Either way, you're talking about a mid-level pick for one of the most dominant forces in the middle of a defensive line in the entire National Football League. I'm talking about Big Haloti Ngata going from Baltimore to the Detroit Lions for a mid-round selection. Look, if I'm the Oakland Raiders, if I'm one of these teams like Jacksonville out there looking for defensive line help, hell, if I'm any team with a lot of money, because the reason why the Ravens couldn't have him back, they said, look, we gotta get rid of this guy. So either we're going to have to cut him or we can try to get something for him. That's why they gave him away. Cause they basically gave him away. A fourth or a fifth round pick? Are you kidding me? I know, like the Raiders with Reggie McKenzie, they value draft picks because Reggie McKenzie does his damage through the draft. We saw that last year. But are you kidding me? You don't get Haloti Ngata in the fourth or fifth round. If that's all the Ravens were asking for, don't you think all 31 other teams in the league should have been picking up the phone and calling the Ravens and seeing what do they need to do to get their hands on Haloti Ngata? If that's all you want, hey, I'll give you a fourth round pick. I'll give you a fifth. Hell, I'll give you both of them if you want them bad enough. But again, you got to have the cap space because his number is big, and that's why the Ravens felt like they needed to cut bait. But that's a huge move. What you've done essentially in Detroit is you've gotten rid of one problem and you've got another in the interior of your defensive line. Huge pickup for the Lions. You lose Ndamukong Suh, you gain Haloti Ngata. They're not the same player, but damn it, both of them are dominant in their own rights. If you're the Lions, you feel good. And I'm going to tell you right now, Detroit, the Miami Dolphins did you a huge solid because they saved you from yourself. You're about to give Ndamukong Suh one of the biggest contracts in NFL history for a defensive player, and it was going to cost you in about 2 years. Good thing the Miami Dolphins bailed you out. Now look what stumbled upon your doorstep. You got Haloti Ngata for being patient, or at least because somebody else bailed you out. Either way, big get for the Detroit Lions. And finally, the biggest trade of them all, it seems like. Well, I don't know. I don't know if that Jimmy Graham to Seattle trade can be top. That's a pretty big one. But then you get Sam Bradford being traded to Philadelphia as the Chip Kelly Express continues to chug along the train tracks. What the hell is going on in Philadelphia? Nobody really knows at this point. Like I said before, I'll say it again. Either Chip Kelly is going to successfully turn the Philadelphia Eagles into the Oregon Eagles or the Philadelphia Ducks. You call them what you want. Either he's going to do that or he's going to crash and burn this Philadelphia Eagles franchise miserably. Either way, he's doing a hell of a job of transforming this team into something we've never seen before, because we don't know what the hell we're seeing with this Eagles team. They look nothing like the team we've seen over the last 4 or 5 years. No D-Jax, no Shady McCoy, no Trent Cole, no Todd Hermans. None of those guys, they're all gone. It's crazy. And now you can go ahead and add Nicholas Foles to that list. He's been traded to St. Louis for Sam Bradford, and I don't really know the compensation, but this is the intriguing part about this trade. The two teams, Rams and Eagles, are going to swap a pick in the draft. If that is in the first round, do you know what this means? It's just another means of Chip Kelly trying to get to Marcus Mariota. If he goes from 20 to 10, cuts that deficit in half, you know Chip Kelly is going up to get his boy Marcus, because nobody wants to move back to 20, let's be honest. And nobody wants to give up the type of compensation it's going to take to go from 20 to, let's say, 5, or 20 to, let's say, 6. Nobody wants to give up that kind of compensation. But to go from 10 to 6, from 10 to 5, hey, you can do that in your sleep. And so Chip Kelly, I don't know if it's a first round pick, so don't quote me on this, because again, it's a pick. And the Rams are also sending a fourth round pick. Don't know what they're swapping right now, but I tell you what, if it's a first rounder, man oh man, my mind is playing tricks. Chip's playing tricks on me. Chip's playing tricks on us. Uh-oh. So, and this is a big trade for Sam Bradford, because even if the Eagles don't get Marcus Mariota and that thing falls through, they still have a quarterback on their roster in Sam Bradford that maybe Chip Kelly feels good about, and maybe he gets to resurrect his career. We'll see what happens. That's a big cap number that you just got rid of Shady because you swore that his number was too big. Well, you just inherited Sam Bradford's cap number, so we'll see how that happens for the Philadelphia Eagles. But I'll tell you this much, Chip Kelly has the NFL spinning on its head right now. Everybody is baffled by what Chip Kelly is doing. And again, I got my popcorn ready. I'm sitting back and I'm watching the show, because Chip Kelly is entertaining us all with his theatrics in Philadelphia. Look, there's an end game somewhere in here with what Chip Kelly is doing. We just don't know what it is quite yet. We'll find out all together. It should be a lot of fun. But those are your trades. Free agency, I told you, it's been crazy. Stay tuned. We're going to keep breaking this down. Have a good one. I'll be back soon.
There's plenty more where that came from. While you're here, subscribe to the channel. If you want more Louie T, be sure to follow me on Twitter at In The Lab Room, or you can like the Facebook page at In The Lab Room. That's In The Lab Room on Facebook and at In The Lab Room on Twitter. Don't forget, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already done so.